Good morning, Patriots. On today's morning news, we have a chance to buy luminarias for Relay for Life.
Also, an update on AR tests, and the biggest basketball tournament of the year is coming to a close. All this and more with Sam Starr's weather report coming up on the morning news.
I'm Olivia Haycock.
And I'm Erin Waterhouse. Today is Monday, April 2nd, and here are today's news and announcements.
ITS members, our next meeting is April 3rd. We will be electing next year's officers, talking about the end of the year dinner, and ordering your end of the year awards. All members must be there from 2:30 to 3:30 in room 242. And don't forget to wear your new ITS shirts. Join us in the fight against cancer. April 2nd through the 13th, luminarias will be on sale for $10 at lunch. This $10 donation can go towards the team's $100 goal if they are participating, or just towards the American Cancer Society. When you purchase a luminaria, you honor a cancer survivor or someone who has passed away from the disease. You can decorate your bag at lunch, or we can decorate it for you. Light a luminaria for someone you love.
There are new AR tests in the library this week. These include Aces Up by Lauren Barnholt, Kiss by Ted Decker, Everneath by Brody Ashton, End of Days by Thomas E. Snagoski, Fugitives, Escape from Furnace by Alexander Gordon Smith, and Bone Man's Daughters by Ted Decker. Tuesday, April 3rd is the next meeting of the National Art Honor Society. Bring your art pieces appropriate for the annual art show to discuss and match. We will be meeting at 2:30 in room 131. If you cannot be present, please inform an officer or Mrs. Lusader. And the Independent School District Foundation has partnered up with Tabitha's Clothing for a spring clothing drive from March 26th through April 6th. You can drop off any gently used clothes or new socks and underwear to any Independent School District schools. Help would be appreciated.
The Gay Straight Alliance will be meeting after school on Tuesday, April 3rd in room 218. Please bring food or drink to share, money for t-shirts, and $3 for a Day of Silence button. We will be discussing exciting upcoming events for our club. Also, the annual Mystica Fielder NFL District Dinner Theater is coming around once again on April 17th to raise money for nationals and camp scholarships. The dinner of the night is an Italian pasta bake, salad, bread, and dessert. The show is a variety show created by the competitive drama students and is a bit like Saturday Night Live. If you would like tickets to the show or would like to donate, let Ms. Adams know right away. Tickets will be available at the door and are $10, but only seating is up to 300.
The weather seems like it's going to be perfect outside. What do you think, Sam?
It's very close to that for sure. Actually, today alone, we have a chance to tie, if not break, the record again. Looks like this summer is definitely going to be a summer of records. This morning already, we're at about 69 degrees, very, very warm. Later on today, we can see reaching about 86 degrees with a slight breeze and a little bit of cloud cover. Moving on tonight, we have a drop to only 60 degrees and a very small chance of rain. And then tomorrow morning, it's going to rise even higher than it was this morning to about 72, and once again, another chance of rain. Looking at our week-long forecast, we can see the chance of rain continuing on through Wednesday, and then the highs actually dropping slightly during this storm season. And then once we get further on until Saturday, we have once again another chance of storms. But between that, we can see very mild and very light temperatures. Now going back to the desk with Erin and Olivia.
Thanks, Sam.
Crew for Steel Magnolias is needed to help move props. Please meet Mr. Armstrong in Mr. Meyer's room at 3 o'clock on Thursday, April 5th. We need as many A-plus volunteers as possible for the Blackburn Spring Carnival on Friday, May 4th, 4:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. If you're interested, you must sign up with Mrs. Dindish no later than April 13th. And cheerleaders, there will be a brief meeting after school in room 308 for those interested in THS cheerleading for 2012 to 2013.
And in sports, track and field competed last Friday at the Rusty Hodge Invitational at Blue Springs South. On the boys' side, Roy Bay placed second in the 100-meter dash and first in the 200. The 4x100-meter relay team of Bay, Dimitri Dinwiddie, Jared Barron, and Ben Sander placed fourth. In the 2 mile, Cole Rockhold and Justin Brown placed third and fourth. And in the shot put, Marcellus Corbin placed fifth. On the girls, Sarah Ruckman placed second in the 800-meter run. Also, boys varsity baseball went up against Blue Springs South last Friday. The team had a hard-fought game, but lost to the Jaguars 2-1. JT Hayes had a slow hit to third, allowing Ruddy to score the lone run. And today for lunch, we are having tetrazzini with a breadstick or grilled chicken salad bar.
And on the grill line, we have a spicy chicken sandwich with baked fries or mini corn dogs with macaroni and cheese. For the latest school headlines, visit THS Media online. Click on the KTSN TV 15 news link to see a rebroadcast of the daily morning announcements. You can now follow us on Twitter by texting 40404 and type follow at THS News Media. Log on to Facebook and like us, and you can now view the morning news and Patriot Vision at youtube.com/THSNewsMedia. Click the subscribe button and stay informed on the go.
And we would like to wish a happy birthday to Kaylina Ferguson. If you would like your birthday announced or another announcement on the show, please email Ms. Namirathi the day before by 3:20. Include Kathy Glasgow on general announcement emails. Any email sent after this time will not be included the next day. In the email, please list the dates you would like your message to appear on the morning news. March Madness is finally coming to a close with the final championship game occurring tonight at 6:23 p.m. Eastern Time.
The Kentucky Wildcats and the Kansas Jayhawks are the winning teams to go into the game from the final four games that occurred over the weekend.
Both teams are excited for this matchup and are hoping to come out strong against their opponents and leave the other team empty-handed.
Well, it's all laid out on the line now. And now, if you so choose, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And that is all we have for you today, Truman.
Have a great Monday and enjoy the beautiful weather outside.